Duke Human Vaccine Institute is best described as a biotechnology enterprise within academic settings. We make vaccines, mainly HIV-1, but also influenza, malaria, now for COVID-19.
We do a lot of work across departments, work that bridges basic science as well as clinical research.
While our ultimate goal is to develop products that can help human health, we also are really interested in the basic science questions that then give us the knowledge to be able to make those transformative discoveries. If we go to our most recent example with SARS-CoV-2, we worked as a large team to really quickly find antibodies that might be able to prevent infection. And quickly we were able to come up with vaccine designs that could be tested. My team currently researches vaccine development and also antibody countermeasures. We design proteins that allow us to understand the immune response to vaccination. My laboratory and the Tomorrow's Laboratory collaborate together in trying to understand results from preclinical testing and how that might translate to humans.
The most important part of our work is discovering new aspects of the immune response by pulling in knowledge from other fields, such as biochemistry, computational biology, engineering. Working with Dr. Premavada Acharya, she can drill down even deeper to give us a very close-up visual of how the antibody is interacting with the pathogen.
Dr. Acharya has world-class technology for electron microscopy. Through these high-resolution atomic-level interactions, she's able to tell us at a molecular level how the antibodies work.
We solve structures. It's a technology that we understand well and we know well. So when COVID-19 hit, we could quickly tie it all together to understand something we had never looked at before. Investing in basic science research is important because it is a key component of applied science. Anything that is translated into something useful at this point, it has years of basic science behind it to support it.
People is what we really need to invest in. The early stage investigators who are really thinking about these problems for the very first time are the most likely to come up with something novel. And we really need to give them the tools, the technology, and the support that they need to carry through with these ideas.
Significant financial resources allows us to be able to really go after multiple high-level ideas. It allows us to build these large teams that have many different multidisciplinary expertise. The individuals within the Institute are all really dedicated scientists. Being a scientist is part of who they are. They really feel like what they do is important. I believe that motivates all of us in this building to keep going and to hopefully find the next big discovery.